Let us study about the deflection of a moving charge by a sector of magnetic field. In this figure, you can see between two parallel boundaries in a region of width D, a magnetic field sector is created. And the value of magnetic induction is given as B. Now, if a charge particle with a charge plus Q moving with a velocity vector V enters into the sector of magnetic field in the direction normal to it, we know by right-hand palm rule, the magnetic force will act on it in upward direction that you can calculate either by Fleming's rule or right-hand palm rule. The magnetic force will act on it in upward direction. And along this line only, there exists a center of circular path along which it will move. And with respect to this center, when the charge particle will move, and in this situation, the radius of the circle can also be given as mv over qb, which we already studied. And when it reaches the other boundary, it will be ejected out tangentially. Later on, it will continue to move in the straight line. And from the original direction of motion, you can see the direction is deflected by some angle. And here you can see this is the angle of deviation delta by which the charge particle is deviated. So, we can say by using the sector, we can deviate the charge particle to any extent depending on the magnitude of B as well as the width of the sector. And this delta we can easily calculate, like in the situation if this angle is delta, this will be pi by 2 minus delta, and hence this will also be delta because this angle is 90 degrees, so this will be the deviation angle delta. As the sector width is D, here we can write in this triangle sine delta we can write as d by r. So here angle of deviation of charge particle by the sector can be given as sine inverse of d by r. If we substitute the value of r over here, delta we can write as sine inverse of qbd over mv, that is the total deviation suffered by the charge particle in its motion when it passes through the sector of this magnetic field of width D, provided here the value of sector width should be less than the radius of the charge particle. Here you can see if this D is more than the radius of charge particle, it will not reach the other boundary. It will complete the semicircle and come out like in this situation. If another charge Q moves with a velocity V such that V is small, and in the line of magnetic force, if the radius is small because it depends on the momentum of particle, and if the speed is less, the radius will be less, it will complete the semicircle. As we can see here, it will not be able to reach the other boundary, it will come back in the same direction. So here deviation angle will be equals to 180 degree or pi radians. This is the way how we analyze the motion of charge particle in the magnetic field.